Good morning. For those of you who I have not met, my name is Chaplain Jonathan Alexander, and I serve as the chaplain for Base National Capital Region in the Coast Guard headquarters. And I want to thank all of you for being here today as we take a moment and we honor the life and the service of Commander Molly Waters. We gather today to comfort each other in grief, especially Molly's family, her mother Marion, stepfather Bob, her father Jim, and her sisters Jeannie and Rachel. And we're profoundly sad at the tragic incident that Molly endured on Monday morning. But even in this sadness, there's this moment of joy as we remember her life. In Molly's ICU room, right down the hall, there's this dry erase board. And it's got a lot of important information on this board. But perhaps the most important information on this board is in a space that says patient information. And you might think that it has a bunch of medical information, important data about Molly, but it's really about her life. It's about who she is. And her sister Jeannie wrote this in that space. Coast Guard Cutterman, big sis to Rachel and Jeannie, distinguished marksman, champion bodybuilder, can make fine chocolates, marathoner, cat mom to Casca, writer, has books on Amazon, the neatest, tidiest, cleanest, most organized lady, owns a house and land in Wyoming. And I think we could all agree that we'd need a few more dry erase boards in that room to capture everything about Molly's life. And what I'm imagining is that you have a dry erase board in your mind and on your heart, and you'll treasure those memories about her life. And I hope sometime, whether today, in the weeks that come, that you'll share some of those memories, those stories, because those stories are restorative and they're redemptive when we share them about the impact that Molly has had in our life. And perhaps one of the greatest things that can be said about Molly in this moment is her commitment to the Coast Guard's values. Honor, respect, devotion to duty. And those of you that know Molly, you know this. Those just weren't Coast Guard values. Those were her personal values. It's why we're here in this moment, gathered in this hallway, because Molly lived a life of service, a life of giving her life away for others. And even in her death, she will continue to give her life away to others. And so today, as we say goodbye to our daughter, our sister, our shipmate on this side of eternity, as we say goodbye to Commander Molly Waters, Molly would want you to know that there's hope and there's comfort in God, in His Word, even in this minute. Many of you have heard the words of Psalm 23. Let me read them. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for His namesake. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for You are with me. Your rod and Your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You've anointed my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and loving kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Would you join me in prayer? Eternal Father, creator and author of life, we come to You this morning to honor a life that is precious to You, the life of Molly Waters. God, and as we struggle to say goodbye, we lift up our sadness and our grief to You. We ask that You would comfort Molly's family as well as her shipmates who are here and those who couldn't be here. God, in Your goodness, would You please bring an abundance of Your gentle healing mercies. In this moment, would You grant us the awareness that each of our days is a true gift from You, to be lived preciously and wisely in hopeful expectation of eternal life in the divine presence of those whom we love. We pray all of this in Your good name. Amen. Now, may the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace. Amen.
And salute. Three, Ready, two.
If I could have just a moment, on behalf of the office, on behalf of Molly's family, on behalf of Molly's friends and shipmates, I want to thank you all for coming out so early this morning and to take this time to honor Molly. When I heard last night the time change, I had a doubt in my mind and in my heart of what this morning would look like. And you were a part of proving my doubts wrong, a big part of proving what a character, what a type of person Molly was, and what it was like to know her. So I thank you very much on behalf of, again, her Coast Guard family, on behalf of her family and friends who will always have her in their hearts. So I really like the chaplain's words regarding the dry erase board, and I would just encourage all of us to take a snapshot of that dry erase board in our minds and that we never lose it, so Molly lives on with us. So thank you very much. Have a blessed day, a wonderful weekend. Thank you.